Send. Send. Why won't you send? I have some great editing software on my computer, but I shoot most of my video on my phone. And that means I have to get this to talk to my computer, to send the files over, to convert them, to do all sorts of bits and pieces, which when you're in a hurry, you're on the road, it's time consuming. So sometimes I use the iMovie app. Today, I'm gonna show you how you can do some simple editing on your phone using the iMovie app. But for those of you that may be a little bit more advanced in iMovie, I'm also going to share some tips and tricks that you may not have known about. I like to use iMovie in a horizontal format because it just gives you a little bit more room to play with all your clips and stuff. It doesn't matter which way you shot the video, it's just the way I have my phone around. To start a project, click on that plus button and you have the option of a movie or a trailer. We're just going to go with movies today. Trailers is something we may cover again. And now you can select whichever clips you want to add to your film. So I'm just going to click two here and click create movie. And as you can see, it's put them in there in the order that I selected them. Let's just have a watch through of that. Okay, there's two problems with this. Number one, they're in the wrong order. I want me picking up the glass and then me drinking the water. And secondly, you saw there was a transition, a fade between the two clips, which can look great, can look really great. But in this case, I think it should be a sharp cut. It should be me picking up the water and me drinking it. So the first thing I want to do is I want to move that second clip. So we do that by clicking onto it. And then you just lift it up with your finger and put it at the beginning. Now let's watch that through again. Okay, much better, but we've still got that crossfade, which I'm not mad about. And that's represented, you can see there's a box in the middle there with two arrows kind of pointing at each other. That's the fade or the cut. So if I click on that box, you can see there's lots of different options there for me to go through, but I just want a straight cut, which is the straight line there. So let's swipe back to the beginning and click play and watch that. Okay, that's a lot closer to what I want, but you see there was a little jump. It's like there was too much at the end of one shot and too much at the beginning of the other. So I want to trim down those shots. And to do that, you just click on the clip you want to shorten, and you just pull your finger across until you get to. So I want me just lifting the glass, but I don't want it going out of frame. So say there. So swipe all the way across and see what that looks like now. Much better. Now I could play with the second clip and just fine tune it until it gets better, but that's the general gist of it. So now I have my film, me picking up a glass, me drinking the water. Right, but I've been using iMovie to edit, and when I try and create a vertical video, which I need to, for Instagram and Facebook and stuff, it crops it to a square. What's the story? Here's a video I created earlier, and each clip should be vertical, but as you can see, as it's playing through in iMovie, it's cropped it to a square. The solution is just each individual clip you will need to resize. So you click on your clip, click on the magnifying glass at the top right-hand side there, and now I can zoom in. Yay, vertical! And I will need to do this for each individual clip. And now if I swipe by and just play through, make sure I've got it all right. Yay! Perfect for my Instagram story. Now that video is very pretty, but a voiceover would add a little bit of context to it. How do we do that? Click the plus button, and you can see if I scroll down, there's the option to click voiceover. And the voiceover will start wherever you have your cursor. So you see I've got it right at the beginning of the first clip. Click on the record button, and it will count you down. One of the nicest things about remote working is that it's not a chore to get your exercise every day. It's actually very pleasant going for a walk at lunchtime and spying on all the posh houses that are close by in this beautiful part of Spain, near Estepona. Now that I've done that, I can review it so I can listen back to it or I can accept it. And you can add background music. You can add sound effects all from iMovie. Just click on the plus button, scroll down to audio. You can use that theme music. It's completely free to use. There's no copyright issues, so you can choose from any of those there. Let's go for modern. Click use. And you can see it just pops it in there. Now, sometimes the music will be a little bit overwhelming. It'll be too loud for your voiceover or vice versa. So you can actually click on that. And you see, you can change the volume. You can go up or down on the volume. If I want to add a sound effect, it's the same thing. And I think I deserve a round of applause. I can click that in and move it into the end section where I'm spying on the neighbours. What am I doing? That was me giving a hat tip to Mark Orr from Pocket Video School, who taught me this hack. I want to put an image so that it sits just in the bottom corner of my video all the way through. But iMovie doesn't let me do that. It doesn't let me create an image overlay. But there's a hack for that. Thank you, Mark. One of the nice features in iMovie is that you can overlay one video on top of a second video. So you can actually make it a little square in the corner, or you can get it to take over the whole frame. To do that, I click on the plus button, go into my moments, find a video that I want to overlay. So let's just go with this one for now. And you can see I've got lots of options. I can just take the sound from it. I can make it a full overlay. I can put it as a little box in the corner, or I can make it half and half. Let's just go for the little box. If I click that little cross in the corner, I can move it around and put it wherever I want in the video. That's great, but I don't want to put a video on top of the video. What I want to do is I want to put a still image so that it sits in the top corner of my video all the way through. This could be a logo, it could be something else. I've made that image, but iMovie doesn't let me put it in as an overlay like I have here. So Mark's magic tip is to create a screen recording of that image. What am I talking about? I've found that image in my camera roll. If I swipe up from the bottom of my phone and I click on that screen recorder, it will record the screen. To get rid of all that background stuff, I just click on the image itself, and I should record that for as long as I want that to remain on screen. Now I've got that screen recording of my still image, I should be able to add it as an overlay, according to Mark. Let's give it a go. Click on the plus button, click on video, because it should be there now. Recently added, and there it is. Click onto that, and you can see I've got all those options again. I want to make it a square in the corner, so I'm going for that one. And it's added it in. I just need to put it in the right place now. And to do that, I click on my recording, highlight it, click on that little cross arrow at the top, and I can make it smaller, and I can put it where I want in the shot. Let's play that. That's looking better now, isn't it? Perfect. And that's it, I'm done. Let's have a look at our full video. One of the nicest things about remote working is that it's not a chore to get your exercise every day. It's actually very pleasant going for a walk at lunchtime and spying on all the posh houses that are close by in this beautiful part of Spain, near Estepona.